Hi guys, it's Curtis here. Super excited to welcome you to some new videos that we're going to be doing that the worship leadership has thought about doing for a while now, and excited to actually see these happen. And we're so excited to be able to give you material to go through that will make your experience as a worship leader hopefully more enjoyable and more efficient. This specifically, we're going to be talking about in-ear mixes, which can be really, really difficult. A lot of times you hear too much, or you hear too little, or you can't hear anything at all, or you hear that random buzz in the background, and it's like, what the heck is going on with my in-ears? And so we specifically, Paul is going to walk us through a journey of a good, healthy mix, so that way, first of all, you can enjoy worship and that you yourself can enjoy, but also you can hear those around you and have a profitable mix that actually is going to be able to let you gel as a team, let us gel as a team better. And so overall, we can have a better sound, but also enjoy what we're doing more. While doing this, it's probably going to be best if you have in-ears on yourself. So a pair of headphones, anything like that, where you have a multi-sided mix, you're going to get the most benefit from this specific exercises with that type of a headset on. Otherwise, I'm going to turn it over for Paul. We're so thankful for you, and we hope that this helps just kind of solidify some of the tips and tricks that you can do while you're here on the worship team. So I'm going to turn it over to Paul and enjoy.
Thank you, Curtis, and thanks, guys, for being here to check out this tutorial on how to use the ears. Appreciate you guys taking the time to get this information, get this knowledge, so you can have an enjoyable experience playing with the band. So it's always a lot more enjoyable and a lot more musical, honestly, just to be able to hear each other and to be able to hear, you know, the entire band and not just you and maybe the leader and maybe a drum here and there, okay? So I'm going to walk you through this, and what we're going to do is we're actually going to play a mix that was recorded this past Sunday. And so you are going to be able to hear the mix that we're going to be dialing in right here on your headphones. Hopefully you have headphones in there. And when I pan things right and left, it should go right and left in your ears. The volume will go up and down, and we'll see if we can get a good mix together. All right. So what we're going to do first here is I'm going to just walk you through the basic controls of these LiveMix boxes that we use. Okay. There's two mixers on each box. You can see A and B here. All right. So A side is blue, B side is red. And as you can see, this one is for the bass player and the guitar player up on our riser here on stage. We're going to concentrate on the blue one today. And what we have right now is everything, all the volumes are at zero, and everything is panned right to the center, which means all the audio is coming right down the middle at you. Okay. And I'll explain more about that later. But let's go over our basic controls here real quick. We have the master volume right here. As I turn that, you can see it goes up and down on the meter. We keep that about 3/4 of the way up, right on this line right here. That's about where a good starting point for a mix would be on the master. This is called the me control, and we're gonna get to this a little bit later, okay? This is one of the main controls you use, the adjust, volume, and pan, okay? Important to note on all these knobs, they're not only knobs, but they're also buttons. You can push them and they have different functions, okay? This is the one we use the most, all right? So master, me, adjust, again, we have A and B. Then we have our touch screen right here. If you wanna adjust a specific channel, so lead vocal, which is usually myself or Curtis or Amy, you just touch it there. If you wanna adjust the red volume there, keys left down here and so forth, okay? As you can see on the touch screen, we've got two pages. We've got 1 through 12. If you push this button right here, we've got 13 through 24. You can also access those channels with these buttons down here. If I know I'm on channel 5, I just hit 5, it takes me right to 5, okay? So that's basically the front panel, and we have one more section to show you here. If you see in the middle, it says accessory channels. If you push this, it takes us to 4 extra channels. Ambient mic, and what that is there's a microphone here and a microphone here actually on the unit. And so it will hear just like if your head was right here in place of the unit, like two ears here, okay? So it will hear everything around you. That can be good, that can be bad. We'll talk about that later, okay? The intercom, if I want to talk to anyone else in their ears, using these mics right here, I just push and hold whatever channel I'm on. It says active right here. my voice is now going to all the ears if you have your intercom channel turned up like this, okay? So there's an internal metronome. We don't ever use that. We've had these for several years and we've never used it before. So probably not worry too much about that one. Aux input is always where we have our click track, okay? Our click track is going in right here via an iPad off to my side here. And I'm gonna play it here. Hopefully it's not too loud. I'm gonna start it. You'll see it's getting signal because you have a green flashing right there. And I'm gonna turn it up with me, the adjust knob, and you can hear it coming in there, okay? That is where we do our click track. So everyone needs to hear that. If you come in and say, whoa, that click track is killing me, you go to accessory channels, aux input, and adjust up or down like so, okay? I'm gonna turn that all the way off for right now. So we're gonna go back to our first page here and let's talk about volume levels, okay? So there's a way that I use to kind of get things at a good volume level so you can have an enjoyable mix, okay? So I'm gonna just run that down for you real quick, okay? So levels, now first of all, I said this before, but if you start your master level right here at 3/4, you can just judge that by that line on the fourth column there. So if you get it right on that line, that's a really good starting point, okay? When you have it up, when you have it way down low here, like this, you could crank your channel way high. You'll probably hear Amy coming in here. Okay, that's just Amy's vocal. Now I have it cranked really high and it's still not very loud. But now if I do the same thing, I have my master up to the 3/4 and I start turn that up. You can see how louder it gets quicker. Okay, so starting point, master at 3/4 right there, all right? Now, the second thing that I like to do, and you might not like to do this, but I think it's a good starting point. I'm gonna go over here and you see where it says crowd right and crowd left. What I like to do is I like to start here and just get those to a nice level where it lets me hear the crowd, the room. There's two mics on either side of the stage. The right, stage right is crowd right and stage left is crowd left. This gives us a sense of the room so you're not just kind of in your own head, okay? It gives you the ability to hear people singing and it gives you just kind of the ability to hear what it's actually like and the energy in the room. So I like to get those up just a little bit as kind of a starting point. The next thing I do, crowd level first, yeah, I'm sorry. Then the next thing I do is myself or whoever's leading, okay? So I played guitar last week here at church, and so I actually went to the lead vocal here and I turned up Amy. You can hear her coming in there. I turned her up to the place where I can follow her, okay? Now, it also might mean if I'm leading and playing guitar, you might have to go here and turn up that acoustic. Now there's no Paul acoustic in this particular mix, but you might have to turn that up a little bit and get a good sense of where the leader's going, because you are gonna wanna follow the leader and be able to hear them, all right? So you've got the crowd levels just a little bit, you've got you kind of turned up where you want, you got the leader turned up, and then you wanna kind of go to your own personal level, okay? So if you're the red mic, if I'm the red mic, I'm gonna turn that personal level up. There is someone coming in on this mic, but not just yet, okay? I'm gonna get that a good mix between myself and the leader, but it's probably gonna be hotter in my mix, my own personal mix, than it will in anyone else's, because you wanna be able to hear where you're at tonally, okay? So you've got your level, and the other thing you can do, I wanna suggest, I'm gonna turn these back down just a second here, okay? The one thing you can do that I'm gonna suggest is if there's not any channels being used, in this case, black and the black mic, and let's say Paul acoustic are not being used. You can actually mute these channels, and you do that by pushing and holding, and you see here it takes me to that channel, black, and I can mute that channel. It shows up as red over top. See, it says it's muted. Not even worry about those, okay? So what I'm gonna do real quick is I'm just gonna get a quick volume mix here. So using that formula we did before, I've got my crowd mic up. I've got my master at 3/4, my crowd mic is up. I'm gonna turn Amy up here. Okay. And then, so she's the leader, I'm turning her up. Now let's say I'm my electric, which this was me on Sunday, so I'm turning it up. Oh, there's some sweet electric. There we go. I'm turning that up. All right. And now I'm going to kind of mold everything else around that. Now that that song just ended. I hope we have another one coming up here real quick. But what we're going to do is we're going to mold everything else around that. Okay. So there's a bumper video, actually. So I'm going to turn up, just start, before we get that next mix, I'm going to start just turning up things just a little bit here. We had five vocals all together here, okay? We had electric. We had an acoustic guitar. You hear that coming in there a little bit? We had bass. You hear that low end coming in. We have two channels of keys. We had a violin player. Here's our drum channels. Turn this down for a second at the master. Two more channels I should mention here. Talkback is Doug or the tech person can talk to us from the back through a microphone. So you want to make sure that that's up so that they can talk to us, usually pretty hot like this. And then the service order is kind of a catch-all channel. And that also carries the vocal effects and things like that. So any type of announcement mic and things like that, those are all going to be in channel 24. Okay. So let's turn our master back up here. Now again, if this is my own personal mix, right here, I'm going to be turned up a little bit louder for myself, okay? So when that comes in, I'll have a better feel on where I am in the mix and how I'm playing. So I'm going to be a little bit louder than I will be in anyone else's mix, okay? So now that we have a decent mix on just volume levels, we're going to move on to panning, okay? Now, all panning is you have what we call the stereo spectrum, okay? Which is, just think of it like this. You're looking out at the audience and the back doors of our sanctuary, that's dead right in the middle. And then way on the far left door behind the stage there, that's extreme left or hard left. And the other door on the other side of the stage is hard right. So hard right and left, center. And then there's all the space in between here, okay? If you have your mix all in the center, so if you see here, I'm going to push this button, it's going to take us to pan. You can see everything is in the center. Okay, go to this page. Everything is in the center, panned in the center. So what that ends up doing when you're listening to that in a mix, my analogy is it's like drinking from a fire hose. All the information is coming right at you, right in the middle. Okay, so what we want to do is we want to take that information and spread it out around. So you can hear things more distinctly, you can hear yourself more distinctly, and you can just have a more enjoyable mix overall, okay? So I'm gonna turn that up a little bit here again, turn my master back up. Just a little bit lower, and then I'll turn it up so you can hear it better, okay? So I'm gonna start with myself here. I'm gonna leave myself right in the center, okay? I'm gonna be right in the middle. The more that you are in the middle, the more an instrument or a channel is in the middle, the more your brain kind of perceives that as being louder. And so in general, you want that to be right at the middle, okay? And so we're going to pan everything else out. I'm going to leave my leader in the middle as well. Let's turn this back up just a little bit. And then I'm going to have the bass right in the middle because it's part of the rhythm section. I'm also going to keep my drums. If you see these, I'm going to keep them right in the middle. Kick, snare, hi-hat, my toms, my cymbals, my drum machine. I'm gonna have those all right in the middle. The rhythm is a good thing to kind of have right up the middle coming at you. You could spread the drums out just a little bit if you like, but we're gonna keep them right up in the middle here, okay? The next thing I want to do here is I want to go ahead and take the two things that have two channels to them. That's the keys and the crowd left and crowd right. I'm gonna pan those really far either side, okay? So if you watch, I'll take crowd right, hit the button for panning, and that's crowd right, so I'm going all the way right. I'm gonna take crowd left, and I'm gonna pan all the way to the left. Now you're hearing the crowd with those mics, just as if you were standing on stage with no ears in, okay? The other thing I'm going to do is I'm gonna take the keys. We have keys left and keys right. I'm gonna take keys left, I'm gonna pan it. I like to pan it pretty far to the left here. I'm gonna go to keys right and pan it pretty far to the right. Gives you a nice big stereo spread for those nice pads and things that they play, our keys players play, okay? Now otherwise, I'm gonna pan things like I hear them on stage, as sort of if I was standing in the middle of the stage. So let's start here on the first page. Lead vocal is gonna be kind of in the middle because I wanna follow that, but maybe the red mic is to her right. So I'm gonna pan that a little bit here. Maybe green mic is to her left. I'm gonna pan that here. Say we have a yellow mic, they're maybe over at the keyboard. I'm gonna pan that a little farther out. And purple, they're over in front of the drum cage. I'm panning that a little bit further out here, okay? The acoustics, I might take those and pan them just a little bit here. We'll take this one. Usually I have one acoustic playing at a time. The electric guitars, I might just put a little bit to the right here. Bass is up the middle. The auxiliary, just like our violin here, I'll probably take Jens's violin here and push it a little bit more to the right because he's way on the right of the stage, so I kind of like to do that here, okay? Again, all of our stuff is, our rhythm stuff is right up the middle. Our talk back is in the middle, and so is our service order because those are kind of catch-all things. Now, if we turn this up, now you can kind of hear how those, you hear more electrics on the right, more acoustics on the left, rhythm up the middle, vocals are kind of spread out. Let's listen to that again. Once everything's panned out like that, like I just did, you probably have to go back and revisit the volumes because those things in the center are going to seem louder. You might have to just revisit the volumes like I just did to get a good mix on that, okay? So let's turn the master back up and hear that. So again, that's like not drinking from a fire hose. All that stuff's not coming right in the center. It is spread out, okay? So a couple more things and we'll wrap this up here, okay? So there are some master output settings. So what that is we're going to go here to Mix Tools and go to Local Mix Options and see it says Master Output Settings, okay? So here we have EQ, Compression, and reverb, as well as overall volume for the unit here, for your own particular channel. On this particular one, the bass is bumped a little bit, as you can see. It's bumped up higher, okay? A lot of them we start right in the center. We'll kind of start this in the center, okay? But if you don't have it as much low end, you can go down here and bump that up. If you feel like it's too muddy, you could take that out. Sometimes the mids will muddy things up, you can pull those down. Sometimes things aren't crisp enough, you can take that and push it up just a little bit, and so on. You can also use the high pass filter. And what a high pass filter is it basically is a gate that lets filters and lets highs through, but doesn't let some of the bass frequencies through. And you can choose different frequencies where to cut that off. So if your mix is a little too muddy, you might want to go to the high pass filter and just hit one of those and see how much of the mud that takes away. The compressor is, you see it says comp amount and then light, medium, heavy. Compression just basically takes your soft sounds, makes them louder, and your loud sounds makes them softer, pulls them all to the middle, and so that might help to glue your mix together a little bit. So you can mess with that, hit that light compression and turn it up a little bit. Okay, we'll turn that up. There's no song going on right now, but we'll do that in a second, okay? So that's the compression. And then, say you don't like to use the crowd mics for the sense of the room, but you want a little bit of space, it feels too dry, you can put a little reverb actually on your mix. You see it says no reverb, small room, medium room, large room, and then how much you want of those things. You can add some depth to your mix that way. So those are some master, and the master output here is just your overall volume limit and so forth, okay? So most people don't mess with those too much. I wanted you to be aware of those, okay? Real quickly, the me settings, this me knob right here, if I go back to the main page, I can push this and set this up. Let's say in my me group, I want to have the lead vocal and the acoustic guitar. So I have just made that my me group. So watch when I go out here. Lead vocal, acoustic guitar. If I grab this knob, you see how they both go up simultaneously, this one faster than this one, okay? But what a me group is, it just allows you on the fly, instead of, you know, turning this up and then going over here and turning this up or down or whatever, it just lets you grab that and turn them all up or down simultaneously. So it's a time saver if you have to turn something up. So that's another option you can do there, okay? A couple other things that are helpful to know about these. If you'd like to save your mix, you got a mix that you really love and you want to make sure that the youth band is coming in and they're going to have all different settings and you don't want to lose your perfect mix, that's okay. What we can do here is I can go to Mix Tools, see where it says Load and Save Personal Mix. I'll hit that. And then this happens to be Justin Cato. He's playing guitar tonight. So I'm going to hit Cato. And I'm going to hit save. Now, I'm not going to save this mix because that'll mess up his mix, but I would save that mix there, okay? And it would ask me if the name is correct. I would say yes, and it would save that. So next time you come back to this mix, say someone has changed everything, you go to Mix Tools, Load Save, and I can go, okay, I'm Cato, Cato, and I would load it, and it would bring all your settings back right away, okay? So that's a really nice feature of that, so you never lose the settings that you love, okay? A couple quick things, just troubleshooting things, and we'll wrap this up. If you find that nothing is being adjusted on here, you're turning knobs, but it's not changing any settings, sometimes that happens with these. All you have to do is grab the Cat5 cable right here, pull it out, wait about 5 seconds, put it back in, it reboots, powers back up, and you have control again. That's a very common thing that happens sometimes. If you think everything is kind of muddy or incoherent in your mix, then one of the possibilities is your ambient mic is on and you're picking up just a lot of room noise and it's making you crazy. Make sure you go in here to your ambient mic and make sure that that's turned off, okay? Something else that could be your crowd mics might be too high, or you might have too high of a reverb setting on in your master settings, as we talked about there. Okay. If you can't hear yourself, that's a common thing that happens. I can't hear myself. I'm turned all the way up. What usually happens there is your master volume is not at 3/4. So make sure that that master volume is at 3/4 and then adjust all the channels and things from there, and you'll have a lot more headroom to make sure you can turn yourself up and make sure you can hear yourself. And also, just remember that we have great tech people at Saylorville Church. They are always willing to help you. I'm always willing to help you. Our other leaders, as Curtis mentioned, are always willing to help you. So just ask. It is beneficial to the band as well as yourself. For you to be able to hear yourself clearly and to enjoy yourself, enjoy your time leading worship at Saylorville Church here. So we want you to speak up and say if there's a problem, because we don't want you to go through a rehearsal or certainly a church service or several services just struggling with your mix. That's not what we want at all. So please speak up and let us know. A couple things I want to say too about this in-ear mixes is it helps to have quality ears. Now, we do provide ears here at the church that are um, that are decent quality. You may want to invest in a higher quality set of ears, and there's different offerings from companies like Shure. They have one called the SE215. That's about $80. Companies called Auclair, Ultimate Ears, companies like that, where you can spend a little bit of money and invest that, and it does give you a much better experience, because a lot of those will seal in your ears a lot better. And when the seal is tighter in your ears, the better your mix can be. So that might be a consideration for you. I also wanted to say that some people say, well, I want to have one ear out, kind of hanging on my shirt there, and one ear in. Just be careful with that. I don't recommend doing that, because you can damage your hearing that way. Your body kind of compensates for the one ear being out, and you tend to turn up the other ear louder to compensate for it, for the room volume, and so you end up blasting one ear out. So as much as possible, keep both those ears in and really work on getting a good mix that way instead of having one out, okay? Also make sure that you have a decent hearable amount of click volume. Even if you're not a drummer or acoustic guitar player, if you're just singing or whatever, make sure you have some volume in there where you can follow that for a down section of the song or something, okay? Don't think you can just dial that out. It does help glue us together and keep us together. It's really just so important to be able to hear, have a great mix, so we can hear each other, to remain musical as a band, and also just to be able to have an enjoyable experience, just listen to what God's doing through us, you know, worshiping Him here in the room during a service. We want you to have an enjoyable experience doing that. So it's just so important we have a good mix. I hope this has helped you. If you have any questions whatsoever, again, talk to me or Curtis, Amy, some of the tech guys. We'd be happy to do in person, you know, hands-on, letting you turn the knobs here and everything, and work it out for yourself with our help here. So if that's you want more, please let us know, and it'd be our pleasure to do that. But thanks for being here today, guys, and checking this out, and thank you again for serving. We so appreciate you guys. Thanks.
And that's it. That's all you need for the perfect mix. But seriously, we know it's going to take time. We know it's probably not going to happen right at once, and we know that you're not going to remember everything in this video. So if you still have questions, ask Paul, ask myself, ask even Amy as we lead. We're here to help, and we hope that this has at least given you a springboard to work off. And like I said at the beginning, we're just so thankful for you. I love serving with you. I love leading with you, and I hope that you don't take that for granted. The privilege that it is to lead others in worship, and it has to be first in our own heart. So I say thank you to you. You'll see more of these, I hope, fun videos that will be helpful and just quick tips to make worship easier and better for you as you serve here at Saylorville Church. Thanks, guys. I hope you have a great one.